Hey guys, it's Lance at Max Sound Solutions, and today I installed a Wi-Fi / Bluetooth 4.2 new card into my Mac Pro that I bought on eBay. I'm going to put the link in the description. It wasn't cheap, it was $120. You can get the Bluetooth 4.0 version for 10 bucks less, or you can just get all the parts yourself. I already had a Bluetooth antenna extension because my Mac Pro lives in the closet over there, and I have the little antenna comes up on my desk, so it reaches all the way over here, and I used to have sort of interruptions in my Bluetooth with my trackpad, but ever since I added that extension, it's rock solid. But of course, with the older Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, you don't get continuity, you don't get handoff, you don't get airdrop, and especially in Monterey, if you upgrade to Monterey, your legacy cards don't work at all if you're using Martin Lowe's Opencore package. From what I understand, the Opencore legacy patcher, which is a different way of doing Opencore, I haven't really looked into it that much, but folks who have used that say they can use their legacy Bluetooth and Wi-Fi cards. But if you use Martin Lowe's package, it does not work. And I think Martin Lowe's package allows you, I know it does, allows you to, you know, boot up into Windows, boot up into different Mac OSs, whereas I don't think Opencore legacy patcher does. So I'm just gonna give you the quick install and try and give you, I'm gonna give you very clear photos. So I'm gonna try and make this really clear and explain the whole process. It's tricky. The little antenna cables are tiny, and I mean tiny. So that's the real clincher, is being able to click those into place. And it just takes a little bit of patience and having it at the right angle. Step one is remove your processor tray from your Mac Pro. Okay, the first thing you want to do is discharge yourself of any static electricity. Maybe wear one of those wrist straps if you want to be extra safe. And the other thing is you want to unplug it from the wall, stand it up on a table. I think when you remove the processor tray, which is step number one, you should definitely stand it up. Don't lie it on its back yet. So remove the processor tray, then lie your Mac Pro on its back to access the Bluetooth card, which you can see in the back there by the fan. Step two is to remove the original legacy Bluetooth card from the logic board. The next step is to unplug the Bluetooth antenna cable, which you see right there connected to the Bluetooth card. This is the old card that's already in the Mac Pro. We're going to be removing this completely, but first step is to unplug the antenna cable. So just grab it with your fingernails or some plastic tweezers and give it a good pull upwards, and it should unsnap from the housing. So there you can see the antenna cable is now loose and detached from the card. So now you want to disconnect the data cable from the logic board, which is right where the arrow is. You want to just pull up. You can grab the three little wires and pull it up that way, gently seesawing it back and forth until it comes out of the logic board. Next step is to remove the screw that holds the Bluetooth card to the logic board. That's right above the gold antenna connector. You need a little Phillips screwdriver, but basically Apple put some Loctite on that thing. So as far as mine was concerned, it was really almost impossible to get it unscrewed without stripping it. So what I did was I rotated the card counterclockwise towards me, which was a little risky. So if the board is at 9 o'clock right now, you want to rotate it downward to 8 o'clock, just a little enough to get that screw loosened. Now the other thing you could do, I believe, is you can just leave this board where it is and not undo that screw. As long as the data cable's unplugged and the antenna's removed, it's no longer in use. So you can just park it on the logic board. It does not have to come out of there. And this is what it looks like with the data cable removed and the Bluetooth card removed. Now I put a little piece of electrical tape on the old Bluetooth antenna that's just dangling there. Now you're not gonna do that if you're gonna use his little extension that came in the package to go to that antenna cable. But I'm using my own antenna extension, so I didn't use his cable at all. And honestly, I think the Bluetooth extension is the way to go. Watch my earlier video on it, because it gives you plenty of slack and you don't have to mess around with attaching his antenna cable to the old Mac antenna, which has very little range. Step 3, attach the 4 antenna cables to the Wi-Fi Bluetooth card. 3 of them are for Wi-Fi and 1 of them is for the Bluetooth. So you want to connect the Bluetooth extender, the female part of the cable, to the Bluetooth card, the new card. And that goes to port 3 from the top, the third one from the top. Then you want to feed the cable underneath on top of the logic board over to where the old Bluetooth card was and connect the other end of the cable to Apple's original Bluetooth antenna that we detached from the original Bluetooth card, and snap them together. Okay, so now that we got Bluetooth attached, we have to attach the 3 Wi-Fi connectors. Now, if you don't have a Wi-Fi card installed in your Mac Pro already, like mine didn't come with them, the wires were just down there and they're labeled 1, 2, and 3. But if you do have a Wi-Fi card in there, you obviously have to remove that first, and you might have the same Loctite issue that I had with the Bluetooth card. I'm not sure because I didn't have one. But regardless, once you get that card out of there, you then want to attach the antennas to the new card. And you've got very little wiggle room. They're very short. Now they are under a clip, so you can remove them from the clip. You just lift up on the top part of the clip and you can pull the cables out, and that will give you a little more slack. I was able to place the Wi-Fi card on the ridge of the Mac Pro here and then get each antenna right above where it needs to be and then push down and pop it in. That to me is the easiest way, instead of fumbling around trying to hold the card yourself. Have the card laying flat on the ridge here and hold it down so it's not moving around, and you can move it forward or back a little bit to get it right under the antenna. And I had to rotate these antennas. I had to kind of bend them around because they really wanted to be aiming upward. So you can twist the cable quite a bit so that it's now pointing down naturally and you're not fighting it. Once you get that, you position the card right under the cable and you push down on the connector and clip, it goes in. But man, it has to be lined up just right. Do not force it or you're gonna bend a pin or something. So just be patient, take your time. There's no rush, and don't get frustrated, because you will. And once you get one, you'll go, ah, I get it. They just snap in. Okay, so the worst part is really over. So now what we have to do is just insert the larger end of the Bluetooth data cable into the 2 pins you see here. And that is the PCIe adapter that our Wi-Fi card will go into. In step 5, we're going to flip over the Wi-Fi Bluetooth card with all the antennas connected and insert it into the mini PCIe card. Then insert the 2 cards, the combo cards, into the Wi-Fi card port on the logic board. Okay, so the next step is also a little tricky. We're going to insert the Bluetooth Wi-Fi card with the antennas attached. We're going to flip that over and insert it into the PCIe card with the data cable connected. So flip it over, and you gotta kind of twist the cables, pre-twist them before you flip it over, because you don't want the antennas to pop off the card. But they're locked on there pretty tight. So you flip it over and you insert it into the mini PCIe adapter as shown. So now that this whole package is together, we wanna insert the 2 cards that are mounted together into the reciprocal on the logic board. I found you have to kind of back the card in first and then insert it. Okay, and now that the AirPort Bluetooth card is inserted into the logic board, we're going to put the final screw in to hold it in place. So I only screwed the bottom card onto the logic board. I think there's 2 more screws that I could have screwed into the upper card to also seat it on the logic board. But my Mac Pro is not moving around. I just didn't feel it was necessary, and I was scared that I might drop one of the screws into the logic board. So I just went with the one screw. So our final step here, we're going to connect the other end of the new Bluetooth data cable into the Bluetooth port on the logic board where the old Bluetooth card was located. So you snap it in there. You want the two wires to be in the upper part of the port, not the lower part. So you just line it up, pop it in, and you should be good to go. Now, to make a long story even longer, I used this Bluetooth extension kit. I originally had it connected to my old Bluetooth card, and then I connected it to the new card. So I did not use his extension that he then wants you to run to the old Bluetooth antenna and connect those. I used this kit. Now, do you need to do this? It just depends on where your Mac Pro is located and what type of signal you're getting to your Bluetooth devices. I absolutely needed it because my Mac Pro lives in a closet. I have a video on the install of this, but just look at it this way, is that if you need more range, these antenna kits are great, and you can connect it directly to that Bluetooth Wi-Fi card, the new one that you are installing. So if you want to go that route, it does eat up a PCIe slot. My graphics card eats up three slots, so it's a double card, and then it eats into the next PCIe slot. So I was able to put this in, even though the graphics card is kind of leaning into that slot. I can't fit a card in there, but I could fit this in the bay door. Okay, thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. Give me the thumbs up or the thumbs down. And of course, I prefer the thumbs up. And I'll see you on the next Mac Sound Solutions video.